I am Chris Wheeler and this is for Off The Block. I'm the executive chef of Stoke Park Club, including Humphrey's, our free AA rosette restaurant. Our clientele vary from our members to A-list celebrities, including Johnny Depp, Angelina and Brad, and Daniel Craig. At Stoke Park, we have 35 chefs. We have 4 sous chefs, 1 in each kitchen, and then there's myself that oversees all outlets. Lamb is one of my favourite ingredients. The actual flavour of lamb is very intense. You can comb it down. We have a lamb shoulder dish where we braise it for like 4 or 5 hours. So it like flakes. It's a bit like pulled pork, but it's pulled lamb. We then remould it and roll it, and then we braise it in stock. And then we serve that with pan-fried lamb sweetbreads. And also that on a barbecue, and a lamb steak, you can't beat a lamb steak if you put a little bit of spice on it when you're marinating it. In summer, it's perfect for a barbecue. At Stoke Park, we use an awful lot of lamb. The signature dish is a mini shepherd's pie with a loin of lamb on roasted root vegetables. It's our most popular dish in the restaurant. So we're taking a classic shepherd's pie, we're making the miniature version, and then we're adding a nice fresh loin of lamb to it. My shepherd's pie obviously is from my gran's recipe, but what we've done to enhance the flavour, the stocks from the lamb bones we've cooked for 48 hours. Nobody can make a stock at home for like 48 hours. We roast the bones slowly in the oven. The secret is to go nice and slowly so the oil comes out of the bones. We then pop them into a big pan. We roast it with some carrots, some onions, some celery, some leeks. And add a little bit of red wine. We then reduce that down again for about another 12 hours. So you're starting off with like a massive pan and you're ending up with maybe like 2 litres of sauce, but the flavour in there is just intense. So when we're making the shepherd's pie element of our dish, we'd pan fry the lamb mince, we'd sweat it off and then drain it to get off the excess fat. We then do a mirepoix of shallots, carrots and celery, just fry them off, add it back to the mince and re-cook it again, add some of the sauce to the meat and then reduce that again and cook it slowly, a bit like a bolognese, so you're cooking it really slowly so the meat becomes really intensely soft but the flavour stays in the pan. Just adding a little bit of water as you to keep as you're cooking it. We then pop that into the mould and we put some piping hot mashed potato on the top. If making mash, always add hot to hot, not cold to hot. You won't get lumpy mash. And then obviously we're doing the root vegetables. So we're going to the garden, we're picking our vegetables. So like celeriac, swede, turnip, all your old fashioned vegetables. We're dicing them up, we're blanching them, and then we're roasting them in the oven with some garlic and rosemary until they come nice and soft. So you've got the natural juices and the sugars coming out of the vegetables. We're then getting the loin of lamb, which is the more tender part of the meat, from the fridge. We're allowing it to heat up a little bit. It's best not to cook the meat straight from the fridge. It's best to let it come up to room temperature. And then we're sealing it. When you're sealing it, you're keeping the juices inside the meat, which will help it become tender. And also the lamb loin, there's no fat. And we're just sealing quite quickly in a little bit of olive oil, and then we're popping it in the oven. While it's in the oven, obviously the flavor is staying within the meat while you're cooking it. And the important is to rest it as well, to leave the meat for like 10 minutes, just resting. Once you think it's cooked, just leave it on the side under the light, and it makes the muscles relax when you slice it. And the meat becomes much more tender. And then we'd plate it up. So you put the shepherd's pie at the top of the plate. And so that's the old fashioned part of the dish, which would remind you of your childhood. And then we've got the modern part. So the nice loin of meat, very tender, very lean. And we've served that on top of the vegetables. And then obviously, normally you serve red currant jelly with your lamb. So what we're doing is putting a fresh sprig of red currants on the top. So you're adding the classic ingredients, but just a little twist. And then we're just pouring the red wine jus over the top. We like to keep our menus quite simple to give the guests a bit of surprise when you serve it. And I think people are expecting a big pie dish of shepherd's pie. When we pop it down, they're like, oh my God, I wasn't expecting that. So you do get the wow factor, which I think is part of coming to a, you know, fine dining restaurant. The love that's gone into preparing it and the way it's presented on the plate. The food you like, but served with love and passion.
Oh, there is a wow factor to the food at Stoke Park. The fine dining in this restaurant is superb. I'm very, very fussy about what meat I eat anywhere in the world, but the meat here is always perfect, and I don't think I've ever left a scrap of meat here.
Really important to know the provenance of your meat. Even the customers are asking, you know, where did your meat come? And I think it's really important. You know, we try to buy as local as we can. As long as you know the quality, the farmer's doing his best to make that animal the best he can for you. And I think it's just using your skills as a chef to bring all them elements together and do the farmer justice. You know, when they're saying that's the best time to buy it, then put it on your menu. I mean, you know, there's no point having out of season food on your menu, because at the end of the day, nobody's going to be happy, are they? We're the end product, and then we want the guests to be happy, but we also want the farmer to be happy and the chef to be happy. So I think it's the whole trail of, you know, where it first came from.